The worst mistake that podcasters make is overworking themselves to the point of burnout. A great solution for this is outsourcing parts of the production process, but that isn't an option for many podcasters. With these following 8 tools, you can save time podcasting, which will help you to stay motivated and keep creating amazing content. Tool number 1 is ChatGPT. Use ChatGPT to research for an episode, get episode ideas, write episode show notes, and podcast introductions. Simply head to open.ai and try ChatGPT. Type in the chat box what you want it to do for you. The more specific you are, the better the outcome will be. For example, I'll write SEO optimized show notes for podcast episode on nutrition, focusing on the vegan diet. And you'll see here that it writes out show notes for me that I can use or at least use to lead me on the right track. A little tip for this is to actually have ChatGPT write your show notes before recording the episode. This way, you know exactly what to talk about. Tool number 2 is Matchmaker.fm. Matchmaker.fm is an online software that will allow you to find and book guests for your show easily. You can filter potential guests to find someone that suits your show and reach out to them directly on the platform. This will save you time with outreach and cold emailing people who may not even be interested. Tool number 3 is Calendly. If you are finding it tedious to go back and forth with guests, trying to come up with a time to record based on both your schedules, use Calendly to make this process simple. With Calendly, you can set up a booking link so that guests can book a time online to record with you based on your schedule. If you're a Riverside user, you can use the reusable studio link to set up this Calendly link one time and never have to update it. Your guest will also immediately get access to the studio in their calendar, so you never have to send that invite email with the link either. For a walkthrough of how to use Calendly and how to use it with Riverside, click the link above. Tool number 4 is Riverside. Learning how to use Riverside can save you tons of time during the recording, editing, and publishing process. Riverside allows you to record high-quality audio and video over the web with the press of a button. Once you're done recording, you can directly export your video podcast to a Premiere Pro timeline, eliminating any download and setup time, or you can edit your recording directly on the platform. If you edit on the platform, you can even take that edited video podcast and upload it directly to your Anchor account from Riverside. In the video linked above, Steven creates a podcast in just 20 clicks using Riverside. You can also go into the editor and create clips from your recording designed for the various social media platforms. Tool number 5 is Zapier. Zapier can automate a lot of things in your podcast based on triggers. You can use Zapier to automate new posts to be published across various social media channels whenever you release a new episode. Based on your specifications, Zapier will trigger a new post when a new item is added to your RSS feed. You can customize what the post says, and you can even pull specific content from your RSS feed to be featured in the post. In the video linked above, Steven will give you a thorough walkthrough of how to set this up for the various social media channels. Tool number 6 is Trello. Trello is ideal for immediately being able to look at what's on your plate and see what you and your team should be working on next. You can track the process of your episode production, assign certain team members to certain tasks, get notified for deadlines, write your show notes or scripts in each episode card, attach Google Drive or Dropbox files. Essentially, Trello can be the hub for all of the content associated with an episode, so everyone on your team always has access to everything that they need. Tool number 7 is Canva's brand tools. Canva is a website full of templates to help you design all types of content. First, you want to create a brand kit with your podcast brand colors, font, and logo. Then, you can browse and edit Canva's pre-designed templates to match your branding and messaging. Save these templates as brand templates, so now you can easily edit them with new content. And tool number 8 is podcastpage.io. Rather than learning how to create a site on Squarespace or on Wix, create a podcast website easily using podcastpage.io. It will help you to create a website specifically made for podcasting, meaning you don't have to worry about plugins that slow down your site or adding episodes manually. The site will import your feed from any podcast host so that it always stays in sync when you release new episodes. It's fully customizable for branding purposes with a visual editor. You can add unlimited custom pages and any additional content you'd like to host on your website, like blog posts, guest intake forms, and profile pages. After trying these tools, if you're still finding yourself overwhelmed, then it may be time to start thinking about outsourcing. We have a video coming out very soon that will help you decide why, when, and how to outsource podcast production. So keep an eye out for that and make sure to subscribe to our channel to be notified every time we post a new video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next video.